how's it going? Hellbound Blues and here with Bodh'aktan, who are here in Montreal to play a show at Club Soda. How's it going?
Very good. Nice to see you.
Oh, awesome. Likewise. So, what can you tell me about the very beginnings of your band? How did this all start?
It was the brainchild of our singer, our lead singer. His name is Alexandre Guichard, and he had the idea of starting the band. Him and the guitarist were living together at one point, and they came up with a few songs, and they decided to start a little band that would maybe play a show or two here or there. You know, no big expectations. And gradually, one by one, we all sort of glommed onto the band, and 150 shows later, we're still wondering where the small part of this story is going to come into play.
Yeah, it works out for the best, no?
Well, I guess so.
Yeah. When did this start off? Like, a couple years back, I think?
3 years ago.
Yeah.
It started.
So, I mean, you guys have exploded quite a bit from then until now. Were you expecting that?
Tu peux pas t'attendre à ça. La seule chose qui fait qu'on se rend compte petit à petit, c'est qu'à chaque fois, il y avait plus de monde dans les spectacles. Là, tu te rends compte que les gens se reconnaissent dans notre musique en venant voir le spectacle. Là, si on a commencé dans les toutes petites salles, ce soir, on est au Club Soda. Donc, c'est cool.
Ouais.
Mais non, tu peux pas t'attendre à ça. Parce qu'au départ, c'était vraiment pour le plaisir.
Ouais, c'est ça.
On savait pas ce qui était pour être avec ça.
Mais c'est encore pour le plaisir. We're still having fun doing it. So. Yeah, that's true.
So, I mean, I was just wondering with the name, you know, I have no idea what it could possibly mean. Where does that come from?
It's a funny name, and you know, we sometimes wonder if it's a blessing or a curse, the name of this band, because nobody can pronounce it. You know, so we think to ourselves, well, you know, it either means that it's a good thing because people will remember that it's a band whose name nobody can pronounce, or it's a bad thing because everybody will, you know, just think it's strange. But the name Bodh'aktan is actually like a kind of a semi-Gaelic word that we kind of came up with, or we reshaped, and it's really a kind of a name for fishermen's boats.
Nice.
That's what it means.
Good choice of a meaning there. So, what can you tell me about the early influences, and even now, what your influences are as a band, individually or as a group?
L'influence vient un peu de partout. Moi, j'étais dans plusieurs groupes punk rock à l'époque. J'ai fait beaucoup de pop. John a joué dans toutes sortes de groupes différents. On a évidemment le côté maritime, parce qu'il y a deux musiciens qui viennent des îles de la Madeleine, deux musiciens qui viennent de la côte nord à Saint-Pierre. Donc, ça, eux autres avaient un passé un petit peu maritime dans leur goût. Donc, c'est le mélange de tout ça. On voulait arriver à quelque chose qui mélange le traditionnel, le folklorique, mais dans une sauce vraiment rock.
Ça marche bien, apparemment,
oui.
Donc, avec vos influences, you know, with your influences, you said that you have a variety of them. And what's weird is that you covered a Rage Against the Machine song,
yeah.
Which is, you know, a bit weird for a band of your taste. Like, how did that come up, you know?
Mais on se dit à la base que une bonne chanson, c'est une bonne chanson. Peu importe que ce soit du pop, du death, une bonne chanson mérite de s'attarder. Puis on est arrivé avec cette chanson-là, puis ça a fonctionné immédiatement. Lui qui avait ses idées pour le violon dans la chanson, donc le plan s'est fait assez facilement.
But you know what, another thing that we find is kind of a nice surprise sometimes to mix different styles together. Think of a band like Rage, you know, which is known for their kind of aggressive electric, well, not really electric, but you know, heavy, kind of
rap,
aggressive rap style. And us with our accordions and violins and bagpipes, you know, so we thought it would be kind of a cool way of encapsulating what this band is all about, you know, the rock and the traditional music kind of mashed together.
You know, going with your latest album that you just released too long ago, how was the process in that? Because the producer who co-produced it, he also produced Marie-Mé's album, which is like kind of a different genre. If you don't know Marie-Mé, she's like a pop Quebecer singer. So I mean, how did you come across him? Why did you decide on him? How did that work out?
Well, tu peux-tu répondre à ça?
Oui. Fred Saint-Gelais est un ami d'enfance. On a été comme coloc ensemble. Puis moi, quand on a terminé nos tracks, je l'ai appelé, je lui ai dit, est-ce que tu voudrais me donner un coup de main pour mixer l'album? Là, il m'a dit, moi, je connais pas beaucoup le côté traditionnel, mais il a écouté beaucoup de rock. Fred, c'est un gros amateur de punk rock, de rock aussi. Il dit, envoie-moi les tracks, on va écouter, puis on va voir. Il m'a retéléphoné une demi-heure, une heure après pour me dire, garde, ça marche. Il dit, il y a des hooks partout. Et puis, tu sais, on est capable de faire sonner ça au rock, puis en même temps d'être capable d'aller chercher vos instruments, puis embarquer avec nous. C'est le 8e Bodh'aktan.
Oui, ouais. Mais peut-être, Robert, tu devais dire c'est quoi le lien entre nous autres et Marie-Marie, parce qu'elle elle nous a dit qu'elle ne sait pas si nous autres on connaît Marie-Marie.
Ah, ben oui. Ben, moi, je suis musicien pour Marie-Marie depuis 10 ans.
Ah, oh, ouais.
Oui, c'est le bassiste pour Marie-Marie.
Ah, ok, ouais.
C'est parti de là, mais je veux dire, avant cette aventure-là, je connais Fred depuis ma jeunesse, mais là, comme c'est là, je fais les deux, je fais Bodhaktan et je fais Marimé.
Nice.
c'est vraiment cool. Marimé d'ailleurs vient souvent faire des chansons avec nous. Ouais. Ah, ouais. Marimé à la base, tout ça. C'est une artiste qui écoute tous les genres de musique, qui a écouté beaucoup de rock. Donc quand elle est avec nous, c'est éclaté.
She actually sang on our first album.
Oh, really? That's really cool. Are we going to see her tonight, maybe?
Maybe. We're performing with her tomorrow on Belle et Bonne. Maybe she might show up tonight, too.
Yeah. All right.
No, no.
Could be a nice surprise. Also, with this album, it was released in English as opposed to your earlier album, which was French. What made you change into English?
By reading. Okay, well, this most recent album is actually in French.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we have, at this point, we have two French albums and we have one English album, but our English album is you might call it an adaptation. It's a translation of the first French album.
Okay.
So, essentially, we have two albums. The first of them exists in both languages, and the second one is just in French.
Are you going to do that with this one, too? Come up with an English one?
It's a good question. I mean, we've been having a lot of interest from the Anglophone markets, mainly due to a company that we're involved with in Toronto, which is called Frostbite Media.
Mm-hmm.
And Frostbite has been pushing hard to get us into college radio rotation in the States and to get us into some showcases and other situations that could sort of promote us in an Anglophone market in the States and in the east of Canada. And so we thought that it was appropriate to do an album in English, and we figured that the best thing to do would be to take some work that we'd already accomplished and just switch it over into a different language and sort of see how it went. And it's been interesting because it's kind of been behind the scenes a little bit. You know, we've been concentrating very hard on the French side of our performances and our music, and almost unbeknownst to us, this album has been sort of growing in popularity in the English markets, and we haven't really been paying attention to it. But it's but we've been, you know, every once in a while we read these reviews of the album and it's like, wow, they really think this, you know, and because it wasn't originally our target market, I guess, and so it's kind of a nice coincidence that it's happening.
Yeah, well, it works out very well. I mean, you guys have toured in different places in Europe, you know, different places in North America, so yeah. You know, and you guys have played really big festivals too. Recently, if I'm not mistaken, you played at the Quebec Festival of Plan de Baham.
Yeah.
And how was that? That must have been, because I went there once to go see Van Halen. Shit ton of people everywhere. It must have been crazy being there and playing for that many people. How was that like?
Ben, écoute, on faisait le spectacle après les Cowboys Fringants,
c'est ça.
Et puis, on jouait le spectacle était quand même assez tard. On se demandait comment ça allait aller avec les gens, et les gens sont restés. On a quand même joué normalement de 35-40 000 personnes qui étaient full dans le spectacle, t-shirt de Bodhaktan. Yeah! C'était un super moment. On a fait ça, cet été, on a fait Lafayette, le Festival international de la musique. Il y a beaucoup de monde là aussi. Le genre de musique qu'on fait a l'air de bien voyager, peu importe le langage.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Yeah, absolutely. It must be fucking awesome, you know, to be able to do that. So, I mean, what's next for you guys after this tour that you have going on?
Well, you know, this album, the two albums actually just came out. Our French album came out on Tuesday, so we're going to be touring that really heavily starting now, like tonight.
Tonight. It starts tonight.
Actually, we already have done three launch large shows for this album. We played in City last weekend, we played in Quebec City on Wednesday, and we played last night in New Richmond. In
yes, Tennessee. Yes.
Yeah. And each show was sold out, and each show
oh, really?
Was incredible.
Course,
yeah, yeah. Awesome. They were really kind of beyond our expectation. We were really surprised and really happy, and you know, we're always a bit surprised that people like us, and that, you know, that we are able to kind of reach people with our music. We have so much fun doing it that it's kind of it's like an added bonus that people dig it, you know.
Yeah.
But yeah. So with the new albums out, we're going to be touring those and pushing hard to sort of basically try and get bigger and better shows all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, in the meantime, continue writing and continue working on our own stuff and see what the future holds. I think we already have tours booked for the festival season in the summer, and we have some pretty fun things coming up, so we're excited.
Awesome, great. Okay, well, before we head out, I just have a random Q&A. So, I mean, you know, given your music, you guys have to drink beer, right?
We drink a beer or two.
A beer or two? Or three, of course. Yeah? What's your favorite type of beer?
Well, you know, we all like different types of beer in the band, but one of the very cool things that we had in this band is that a microbrewery in Saint-Hyacinthe called Les Brasseurs Mont decided to make a beer for us.
Are you serious?
Yeah, so, we have our own beer. It's called La Trois Capitaines, and it's extremely delicious. And if you ever have a chance to get some, I highly recommend it. It's a nice Irish red ale.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I mean, personally, that's kind of become my favorite beer, maybe just because it's the one that I drink all the time.
Yeah, you're like a small scale kiss, man. You guys are like all over the place. You got your beers coming out. Yeah. Oh, I mean, hey, it looks how nice for you guys, right?
Fun.
Yeah. All right, so favorite type of food?
Maybe lasagna?
Lasagna?
Yeah.
No, no, not that. Tofu and okay. Legume.
Well,
look at that. Something.
No, man. Évidemment, oui, j'aime la nourriture italienne, j'aime bien. Bon, c'est assez varié. On mange beaucoup sur la route aussi.
Favorite type of food? Subway.
Straight to the point, yeah. I can agree with both of you on that. Lasagna, Subway.
Yeah, that's good.
But, yeah. So, favorite place you've played so far, or dream place you'd love to play?
So far, Lafayette was
really cool. Yeah, it was amazing. We played it. It was a big international festival, and there were a ton of people, you know. And each week we were there, we played four shows. And each time we played, you know, the crowd kind of got exponentially bigger. And by the time we sort of headlined the Saturday night show,
yeah,
I guess, at the end of the festival, and there were, I don't know, maybe 10 or 12,000 people there, and it was massive. It was really unexpected.
I'm not sure what it was in French.
Yeah, that's it.
There. Yeah. It was like, wow.
Yeah, and Le Monde, aimait ça pareil.
Oh,
you know, they're used to speaking French in
Lafayette. Ils étaient fiers de nous montrer qu'ils connaissaient ce qu'on faisait parce qu'ils nous avaient vus dans la semaine.
Mm.
Donc, chantaient.
Nice.
Puis la vision du public, c'était vraiment cool. Quand tu penses que tu es un petit groupe québécois, toujours dans un gros festival comme ça, que ces gens-là connaissent ce que tu fais, c'est wow.
Ouais,
évidemment, des places rêvées pour jouer, on voudrait faire mais évidemment des gros endroits, le Centre Bell, c'est évidemment ce qu'on vise le plus, pouvoir faire des spectacles pour le plus gros nombre de gens possible, faire écouter notre musique partout, c'est ça.
Well, okay, on the other end of that, worst tour story. That's the worst thing that group of shows can be wasted at work. You guys just like have everything going on, right?
Pas beaucoup, mais
je dirais, la première tournée en France, il y avait des moments que quand c'était vraiment comme moi, you know, we played in some pretty scummy little places the first time we went to France. But you know, we weren't expecting anything else really. You know, we went there and we were like, okay, well, nobody knows who the hell we are. You know, we're completely an unknown band coming from Canada, from Quebec. You know, we took whatever came, and you know, we had an amazing time. We had so much fun, but some of those places were pretty grubby.
Yeah. Well, you don't have to worry about that anymore, apparently.
Club soda is a bit of a step up.
Yeah, for sure, I would say. So, last question. If two bands were to fuck and Bodh'aktan were the child, who would the parents be?
I would say the Pogues and the Sex Pistols.
Yeah, and toi?
Exactement. Oh. Exactement, parce que le groupe initialement, ce qui a fait qu'on joue ensemble, c'est qu'il y a un gars qui a marqué sur Internet. Moi, j'aimais beaucoup de Pogues, et puis là, on s'est téléphoné. Ah oui, comme ça, comme ça. Et puis, la drive, les Sex Pistols. Tu sais, vous allez voir en spectacle, c'est une drive incroyable, c'est naturel. Même si ça, c'est, à la base, c'était comme un peu comme un boys band, les Sex Pistols, dans la manière que ça avait été formé. La drive, wow!
Very nice. All right. So, any last words before we head out?
Yes. Check us out. Bodh.ca. Bodh.ca.
Et puis, venez nous écrire là-dessus, venez mettre des photos, venez mettre des vidéos si vous venez voir le spectacle. On veut vous voir, on veut vous lire.
Thank you very much.
Merci.